Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today I have a bit different content than usual. We have a review of a BeQuiet M.2 NVMe Cooler. The model number is MC1. And we're going to take a look if it's worth it and if you should use one. In my personal computer I have 2 NVMe drives in mirror, and one does have a heatsink and the other one doesn't. And even if in idling, they are always about 8 to 10 degrees difference. And when they get hot, the one without the heatsink gets very, very hot, up to 70 plus degrees, which is definitely not good for the drives. This video, of course, is not sponsored or anything. I'm making a server PC build for a friend. And I'm going to use, again, a couple of drives in mirror and use heatsinks on both. Let's take a look. This is quite simple, actually. Oops. So what do you get? These are the two pieces that will sandwich the drive. You can see it gives you just a bit of adjustment there to press on the drive from the bottom and the top. This feels a bit heavy, it does have some material on it. This is just an aluminum extrusion. The screws are the tiniest that you can imagine, and of course it's a good thing that they have provided the correct screwdriver for those. Here we don't want to get any fingerprints when we remove the protective tape. It does come with instructions in English, and that is always a good thing. And what is the other one? Limited warranty details, okay. So let's put it on the drive. So here is the NVMe M.2 hard drive. I just have it flipped over in case there is some information on the other side. And what we noticed, if we look the instructions, is that there is a notch here on the bottom plate that we need to align with our drive. So we can see here, and so there is a correct side, and it is like this that we need to put it. So I'm taking this protective piece off, and now let's get the drive. Oh, it's very sticky. This looks about right. I'm just covering there. And let's put the top one. I'm using my trusty gloves so I don't get any fingerprints or imperfections on the parts. So this also goes like that. The missing piece here goes towards the connector, so we remove the tape, try to align it. So no, we need this for now. So this actually covers a bit the notch there, so I don't know how we're going to put the screw there after it is placed. So that's a bummer. Oh no, there is also a notch here, so I just have to turn this around. Silly me. And there we go, the appropriate space to put the screwdriver, and the screw is there. Our screw holes are almost aligned. I will press on it so we will get a good contact with the ICs, and then I'm going to put the screws. So there are here, they are tiny, so be sure not to lose them. Is this a magnetic? That's nice. So I'm pressing. I won't tighten them too much. So it is a very good idea to have a clean desk if you are doing this. Put this one. Tighten them now. Also pressing down. And here we are. It feels very solid. Now let's go and take a look at the results. So the first NVMe is installed just right there, and let's run the test. So the system has been idling for about 20 minutes. Didn't make much difference. As you can see, the temperature is almost always 40. It has gone up to 43 after a few minutes. I will use a very old utility to read from the disk and see how the temperature goes. As it is, default settings start. So we see the temperature rise, it is at 45 at the moment. The utility is doing its thing. I'm going to speed up the video now and run the test fully. I've changed the test settings a little bit to this so the test will run faster. So we can see the test has completed. The temperature of the drive is at 46 Celsius degrees, and I can see that the newer NVMe drives don't have such a heat problem as the older ones. Now let's put the other one with the heatsink on it and run the test again. We now have the other one installed there. It definitely looks nice. And let's see how the test performs. So I have left the system idling for 40 minutes, as you can see. And even after so much time, the disk is still at 29 degrees, 11 degrees difference just in idle. To be fair, I will run the test as it was before, so here and here, let half of it run and then run the shortest, just to be a fair comparison. Let's start and I will speed up the video here. Oh wow, it jumped to 40 degrees straight away. So there we go, it went to 41 degrees. I am curious if it will drop soon, but still it is cooler than the other one. I will leave it running for some time just to see if the temperature drops. So I've left it running for a few minutes. Nothing has changed as far as the temperature goes. Let me know in the comments if you think it is worth it. Its cost, I think, was about 11 euros. So let me know in the comments below. So there you have it. That was the review of the BeQuiet MC1 M.2 cooler heatsink. Let me know in the comments if this is content that you enjoy. It would be interesting to do something like that in the future. And thank you for watching. Please consider subscribing and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.